Hello, welcome back to The Break. Let's see what MMA's got for us this week. Santiago Ponzinibbio, old Gente Boa himself. He went out there Saturday night in Buenos Aires, got himself a knockout victory over Neil Magny, then afterwards called out champion Tyron Woodley. Woodley responded, quote, "Take a number, bruh." Which, actually, the more I think about it, the more I think Woodley might be onto something. Hear me out, what if we did this? What if we took all the contenders in any given division and we assigned them each a number that corresponded with how they had done rankings? That's it, rankings. Woodley has reinvented rankings. I knew the idea sounded familiar. Also in Buenos Aires, Ian Heinisch made his UFC debut with a win after writing a truly gripping account of his time as a drug trafficker, international fugitive, eventually a guest of several prisons, both foreign and domestic. You know what I learned reading his story? Jail in the Canary Islands actually doesn't sound that bad. Rikers Island though, yeah, still pretty bad. Donald Cerrone still wants to fight Conor McGregor, still out here acting like the fight's on the verge of coming together. Or, as UFC President Dana White told TMZ, it's, quote, absolutely not true. Then again, he did say the UFC was totally not for sale, right before it got sold. So, you know what this weekend is, right? I mean, after Thanksgiving, after the Black Friday sales, after the UFC airs an event from Beijing in the middle of the night. And oh yeah, Chuck Liddell, Tito Ortiz, three time. You know, I really can't think of any fight that would pair better with two-day-old leftovers than this one. It's almost too fitting. Time now for an update on Floyd Mayweather's New Year's Eve fight in Japan. As of right now, the exhibition bout is on. It's on. But, you know, check back soon. Conditions have been known to change. Let's say that.